My name is Udo Neumann, and since 5 years I'm the coach of the German bouldering team. We have a different coach for the lead climbers, but I'm doing this part of the season. Yeah.
Obviously a massive amount of success for you at the first comp of the year, Chongqing. How was that competition for you? How were you feeling after that event?
The nice thing for me personally is that we had a really nice atmosphere beforehand. We kind of messed up our hotel. We went to the wrong hotel first. After 3 days we realized that nobody else is there. But we did some great preparation when we went to this so-called Olympic Center. We played basketball for half a day, and then later we changed to a playground. And for me it's very important to get into a relaxed atmosphere. And I think they showed sometimes it doesn't work, but in this case, in Chongqing, it translated really nicely into the competition.
That was one of the things I wanted to speak to you about. We've spoke before about this, that the idea that you're not just training the athletes to go out and attack, you're actually training an entire human being and how they think and how they move and work. Yeah. And one of your biggest methods is to get them to do strange and obscure things, different sports. Talk to us a little bit about how you employ that in their training.
Yeah, the bouldering is about creativity, and human beings are creative when they are relaxed, and especially when it's okay to make mistakes. And so I find it really problematic to apply pressure from my side on them. You know, I never tell them, we're expecting a lot from you, and go out and kick some ass or so, because I find that they make their own pressure themselves. You know, it's I'd much rather try to get them into a relaxed mode. And one way to do this is, as I said, is to playfully try new things, where it's totally okay to, since it's new things, nobody can do them from the start on. So it's okay to make mistakes. I think this is a big part of bouldering, you know, that it's difficult. Not everyone is equal. For some people, it's really difficult to get into this mindset, but bouldering is really about mistakes. As Thomas Alva Edison said, I fail myself to success. And that's basically what we're doing, you know? And it creates just a nice dynamics within the group, because in this, all the playgrounds are different, and we basically arrive at this playground, we say, okay, let's try to squeeze all the opportunity this playground has to offer out of it.
It's definitely working the way that you're employing this method with your athletes. You've just recently moved Jan and Yula to the same training facility, and you're working the team more as a collective now. What kind of a basis do you work on a week? I mean, how often do you get these guys in, and what kind of things are you doing in your training?
Actually, we don't have the resources to really that I could have moved them. That was just a lucky coincidence that Jan lives in Cologne too. And this gym where he always trained has exactly to offer what Yule needed in her climbing. And also being with Jan, she really, this winter, she really had a lot of hard moves that she wanted to do, and succeeded just before the Chongqing competition too. And also in general in training, there's lots of coincidences, if you know. But also both of them matured a lot over the last years. You know, Jan said last year he would have done a lot of mistakes, like when he couldn't climb the first slabs on both the qualification and semis. Last year maybe he would have be so depressed that he had, wouldn't enjoy the next problems. And they're all strong, those guys. And so what happens between your ears, that's the most important thing. And they both matured a lot in this respect. So it's, I think my contribution to this is mainly that sometimes I pose the right questions, and they think about it and maybe hopefully draw the right conclusion, but that's about it. You know, there's hardly anything that I tell them, and then they do this, and this it works like this. You know, it's mostly like where I'm saying, oh, maybe try this and this, or I maybe mock them and they pretend, no, Udo, what are you talking about, you know? And then, but in the night, they think, damn it, you know, at least I don't want Udo to mock me like this. And so it's very informal, and I like it this way. As I said, we don't have the resources like the French to really have them all together, and so it's impossible. The French want to have all their people living and training in Fontainebleau, and moving them in their workplace and their university. This is impossible, really. We in Germany, we can't do this, you know. So we really have to work differently.